everyone, and welcome to the new series, From Ashes to a New Beginning, written by Stacey Holt. Artwork was by Pastel Kitty Gore Art on Instagram, otherwise known as Maddie Kitty 1997 on DeviantArt. I highly recommend you go check out her artwork. I will also leave everyone that is collaborating within this chapter, which are Adrian and Cat Noir will be voiced by Shane, I will be voicing Marinette, Ladybug, and the narrator, Tom will be voiced by Brad, Calvin will be voicing Gabriel and Hawk Moth, and M will be voicing Sabine. If you'd like to support this series, you can like, subscribe, and comment. Now, Chapter 6, Forgiveness.
I'm so sorry! I didn't mean to slap you! Adrian, please forgive me!
Marinette cried.
No, that was my fault. I'm sorry, Marinette. Please forgive me.
Adrian said, standing up and leaving. He left her on the roof as he climbed down, feeling like an idiot.
Idiot! Idiot! All you had to do was control your actions. Forget what you were thinking, you can think whatever you want, but control your actions. You can't even do that. You might have just ruined your friendship with her now. She slapped you! How else was she supposed to react? She doesn't know that you're her boyfriend. She thinks she cheated on her boyfriend. Oh, you stupid idiot.
Adrian paced around his room mentally scolding himself, and it wasn't a surprise that Marinette didn't come down that entire day. When the sun went down and the stars started to shine, after making sure that all of the adults were in bed, he transformed and hopped onto the roof. He found her curled up on the roof asleep in the blanket that he had given her as Adrian inside. He walked over to her silently, sitting down in front of her. He stroked her cheek and gently moved the stray hairs out of her face to behind her ear and saw her starting to wake up.
Hello, princess,
Cat said softly.
Cat?
Marinette shot up and threw her arms around him, almost instantly bursting into tears.
Did you miss me?
He said, wrapping his arms around her, feeling her crying into him.
Don't cry, please,
he said, rubbing her back.
Someone kissed me,
Marinette cried.
Huh? What do you mean?
He tried to sound surprised.
Adrian kissed me earlier, and I slapped him. I didn't mean to slap him, but I literally just told him I had a boyfriend. I'm sorry, she cried.
I know you wouldn't cheat on me, princess,
Cat laughed. Marinette looked up at Cat Noir, and Cat Noir smiled down at her, using his hand to wipe away her tears.
Here, to make it better, let's wipe away that nasty residue off you.
Cat smiled. Cat Noir pulled Marinette toward him and kissed her. He could feel Marinette fighting to laugh through the kiss at him, and kissed him back. He pulled her into his lap, letting the blanket lay across both his legs and hers.
So, why are you sleeping on the roof anyways?
He asked.
I was scared to go down there after that situation, she admitted.
Aw, come on, princess. I'm sure he isn't mad,
Cat said.
You didn't see the look on his face, Marinette said, turning her face away. Plus, I also slept out here because I was hoping you would show up.
Marinette blushed.
For me?
Cat asked, his face blushing.
Of course. Who else, you silly cat?
Marinette laughed.
I'll come back soon. Though, I don't think he's angry. Why not go down and talk to him?
Cat asked, helping Marinette to her feet.
But do you really have to go so soon?
Marinette pouted.
I'm sorry. Tis the life of a superhero.
What am I even supposed to say?
Marinette groaned.
Why not ask him to help change the bandages on your arms? They haven't been changed all day, it seems like.
Cat smirked.
Okay, Mom.
Marinette rolled her eyes. Cat Noir kissed her one last time before seeing her off, watching her climb down the ladder. He made sure he heard the door latch shut before he jumped around the side of the house into the bathroom and de-transformed as fast as he could. He took a deep breath and tried to calm his heartbeat as well as his mind, and calmly exited the bathroom to find Marinette sitting back on the bed with her legs crossed looking at him. She didn't say anything to him, however, which was surprising. He expected her to ask him to help her change her bandages, but she didn't. Did she not want to talk to him? Did she ignore Kat's advice? He knew she was stubborn, but ugh, really? He knew he messed up. Maybe he should go apologize again? Adrian slowly walked over and sat on the edge of his bed, carefully watching how Marinette responded to him.
Marinette? I'm sorry for how I acted earlier.
Adrian sighed. Why? She asked.
Why?
Why did you do it? She asked.
I don't know. It just happened.
He said, not really having the answer for her. You could tell that him not giving her that answer made her upset, and he understood why, but he couldn't tell her that he was Cat Noir.
Are you hungry?
Adrian asked, hearing the silence being filled by her stomach growling.
No.
She lied, her arms crossed.
Well, I'll go get us some late dinner anyhow. I'll be right back.
Before she had any time to argue, he had left the room and disappeared down the hallway. She took his pillow and screamed into it, letting all of her frustrations out. A few minutes later, he returned and found her curled under the blankets with the TV on. He not only brought food, but also a few little bags of clothes that Natalie had bought for her to change into. He placed the bags beside the bed on the floor and smiled. He placed a plate in front of her as he sat down on the bed beside her as he ate his own meal, trying to let her see he was not meaning to make her uncomfortable.
Thank you,
Marinette said. He smiled and nodded. They both ate their meals. Eventually, Adrian did crawl beside her and sit beside her and watch TV alongside her. They eventually started talking like they normally did and would start laughing about the television show they were watching. Days have gone by, and Adrian and Marinette have gotten much closer. They spent a lot more time together and just decided to put the kiss behind them. Though Adrian had a few close calls where Marinette almost caught him de-transforming, but she didn't, however. Marinette still remained unaware that her temporary roommate was her actual boyfriend, and Cat Noir still kept coming around to see Marinette every couple of nights, which is why she almost caught him de-transforming a few times. Was it risky? Yes. Was it irresponsible? Also yes. Was it worth it because it made Marinette happy? Definitely. He would give that girl the world on a silver platter just to see her smile if he could. He knew better than that. She would never ask for such things. She was not the type of person to ask for things and take things from people. She was too kind-hearted for that. One morning, though, Marinette woke up before Adrian and she made her way downstairs for breakfast, letting him sleep in for once. She crept down the stairs, making sure not to wake him, and heard her mother and father talking in the hallway to Natalie and Gabriel.
Did you look over the list Natalie gave you of homes?
Gabriel asked.
We did,
Tom said.
We've always wanted to go to the U.S. There are so many cheap homes there.
Sabine smiled.
The U.S.?
Gabriel asked, surprised.
Yeah, I think it would be best for Marinette to start fresh.
Tom sighed.
She's been through a lot, it seems, from what Adrian had told us lately. The fire has taken quite a toll on her.
I see. Well, I wish you and your family the best of luck. When will the closing be?
It should be in a week or two,
Sabine said.
I hope we aren't overstaying,
Tom said.
No, not at all. That will be fine,
Gabriel said. Marinette turned and ran back to Adrian's room, not bothering if Adrian woke up or not as she ran past him. Adrian heard the shuffling of feet run by and saw Marinette run up to the roof. He rubbed his eyes and quietly followed her, wondering what was the matter. He heard her talking to someone and peeked his head above to see her talking on the phone.
Alia, they found a house! Marinette cried. No, that's the problem. It's not in Paris. It's in the U.S.
Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already, you can go check out some of my other videos like Thunderstorm, which is season 1, Downpour, which is season 2 of Thunderstorms, The Butterfly That Brought Us Together, and so on. But for now, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys!